It is a great pleasure for me to stay in front of you today and to speak about the German experience of renewable energies. It is a great pleasure for me because I'm visiting also here at NU my son, Andreas. And so I'm happy to stay also on family issues with you. Please allow me to make some mistakes in my language. I'm not a native speaker. And when I remember on my school time, my teacher told me, you never will learn English. So I'm happy when you can understand me. The German experience in renewable energy sectors is very astonishing, even for me personally, instead of the fact that perhaps I'm one of the most optimistic guys who promoted 10 years and 15 years ago renewable energy sector in Germany. But now in the meantime, we have an innovation and technology process that is very, very important. And it leads to the fact that we now can stand in front of a world where we can solve a lot of crises who are connected together with the energy system. Let me speak first about this crisis, because it is important to see this crisis and the energy issues that leads to such crisis, and then we can see easily that renewables are easy to solve such a lot of crises. We have the peak oil crisis, the scarcity of fossil and nuclear resources with rising oil prices. We have the climate warming crisis. We have the crisis on economic systems. What we have in Europe at the moment, very, very hard, and it is more connected with energy systems than a lot of people believe, because the over debted budgets in Greece, in Italy, in Spain, and even in Germany are more connected with energy taxing, tax exemption for energies, and bring us to really serious, very serious economic problems. And you see, the peak oil in the world is the most overseen problematic situation. We see now a rising oil price, and the most of the scientists see, oh, we do not know why the oil price is rising. There is enough oil in the world, but they overlook there isn't enough oil in the world. This is a research from the Energy Watch Group. I founded it 6 years ago, 2006, made a first independent research, how much oil is in the world and will the world produce in the coming years. And we forecasted with the Energy Watch Group that in 2030 the complete oil production will be only the half of today's oil production. We could see that from 2006 till today we were on a plateau on the oil production of crude oil in the world, and this plateau was, instead of the fact that the world needs more and more oil, look to China, the increasing economy, new cars and others, but the oil fields on the world could not produce more oil. And this is the reason behind the rising oil prices. And this will become a more serious problem when we now come soon, next or over next year, in the time where we have not only a plateau, but a decreasing of oil production. The discussion is only, does it decrease 2% or 6% per year? No one in the world is prepared on this problem on an economic level. We are so dependent on oil, not only in cars, in industry, in heating and cooling sector, but also in chemistry sector, also in agriculture sector. 1/3 of our food is combined with oil. But the other conventional resources, fossil resources, are no solution to fill up the gap what in oil will come. We see the rising coal prices already today on the world coal market. So decreasing in 2008 was a financial crisis, but increased since this time. Here you see the natural gas prices decreasing also. A lot of people think then, oh, we go to unconventional oil, deep sea oil or others, or oil sands in Canada. What will happen with unconventional oil? We must learn from this accident and damage of $100 billion from state of Louisiana set, and BP is willing to pay only $20 billion. And this increasing of the conventional energy resources prices leads to a very serious economic crisis. First, you should compare the tax subsidies worldwide for renewables with fossil. This highlights a first point. Often is said renewables are highly subsidized. No, it is not true. Fossil is highly subsidized worldwide on a high level. And the subsidizing in fossil is increasing very rapidly with the rising oil price, because the governments fear social conflicts when the gasoline price and other prices rising. And so they give more tax money to give the consumers of energy the same price what they are used in the past years. In only 1 year, the tax money subsidy increased worldwide from $312 billion to $409. Next year, we will see a lot of more. This is very serious because we have worldwide public budgets. They are over-debted. And it will lead everywhere, when we go on with this situation, that the national budgets will go to national bankrupts. Nearly no one sees this interconnection, but it is reality. This scientific report came from the International Energy Agency in Paris. On the other side, we have the serious development with climate warming. Instead of the fact that some scientists believe there is no climate warming, it is a climate warming. When you look to the details, the critics are not really on a good scientific basis. And it is clear the world temperature is rising with the greenhouse gas emissions. We have already an overloaded atmosphere with carbon, 390 parts per million, and we have to reduce this. When we go to the target often discussed in the world, like in Durban last climate conference, to achieve and target 2 degrees global warming, I will say I fear it. We have now such climate accidents a lot in the world, even in Queensland with floods, or in Victoria with fire, with burning woods and others, and worldwide big, big disasters. And when we see these disasters are at 0.8 degrees global warming, what will happen when we have 2 degrees? No, we must go another strategy, cooling down the earth, and this is possible. This is possible when we go two combined strategies. First is we have to stop the greenhouse gas emissions, not only to reduce this, because every reduced greenhouse gas emission leads to a higher concentration of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. We have to stop greenhouse gas emissions. This is possible with 100% renewables, because 8% of the greenhouse gas emissions are connected with the use of oil, natural gas and coal. When we cancel this use, we have nearly zero emissions. And we need a second pillar, take out carbon from the atmosphere. I do not want to speak so many in my lecture about this, but we can convert plants to humus soil. We could green the deserts or other. For Australia, a wonderful strategy, but sorry, This picture is not included. This shows a picture from Egypt desert, where 100 years long were only sand on an area. In only 1 year, they grow up new plants in this desert area with Yatropha oil plants. This Yatropha oil goes to the machines to make electricity for the rural villages. And it leads to more greening up the areas that food can grow also. So it is possible to green deserts, to combine it with energy and food production to fight against food shortages and energy shortages. And to go to a 100% renewable world is also possible. This is a plan from Stanford and Davis universities, both from California. You know, Stanford University is very famous in the world because there were some students in the 80s. This student said to the leading opinion in the world, by the way, from the chief of the leading computer technology manufacturers, IBM, in this time. This chief told the students, a personal computer will never come to the world. The students like Bill Gates or Steve Jobs said, we are not interested in his opinion, we work on it. And it did not take 100 years time, what we hear often when we were told, when renewables will come, it is so hard, it will take 100 years. Right. Technology processes are much, much faster. Laptops were in the world within 20 years. We couldn't believe 10 years ago that we could have a mobile phone like this in our pocket. But it is there. Technology processes are very fast. And Mr. Jacobson and DeLucci from Stanford and Davis made a plan for the world to come within 20 years by 2030 to 100% served renewables, the whole energy system, not only electricity system. It is possible on a technology view. We would need about the half in his plan, in their plan, by the wind power. What would we need so many wind power stations, would the most people believe, when we would serve the half of the energy of the world by wind power? They found out with the new ones, 5 megawatt wind power, we would need only 3.2 million wind power stations. And they recognize what it is on a technology process when we can produce in the world yearly 70 million cars and trucks. What would be in 20 years 3 million wind power stations? It is ridiculous to speak about renewables cannot come fast on a technology process. And they find out even on a financial process it is easy. Yes, we need a lot of money to switch to 100% renewables, $100,000 billion. Can you imagine this number? $100,000 billion. This is very great. I asked the Energy Watch Group, what is the fuel bill for the world in 20 years when we do not switch to renewables? Because wind power and solar power, hydropower do not need fuels to operate with electricity and others. What could go also to cars and to the traffic systems? The whole fuel bill for the world on the basis of the prices of 2008 with a price rise of 20% would be $200,000 billion. When we do not switch to renewables. So now my question to you, students, what is cheaper? To go to renewables would save the economy of the world. To go on with the conventional resources will lead to a lot of economic crashes. And it happens already. This is an investment of renewables in the last years. You can go see how fast it goes. And the more we invest into renewables, the cheaper they become. It is a self-accelerating process. And it leads also to high emission cutting. Well, this is an example of Germany. We emit at the moment 960 million tons. When we would not have renewables in the German economy, we would emit 120 million tons more today. It is already the best strategy and the best success in climate protection. And often we were told it is impossible to go a fast way to renewables. In 2000 we had about 6% renewable share in electricity sector in Germany. It was nearly mostly only the old hydropower. Nearly nothing in wind power, nothing in solar, nothing in geothermal, nearly nothing in bioenergy. And we set a target in our law, in our fit-in tariff law, we want to achieve till 2010, 12%. We were told it is unrealistic, it is unachievable, impossible. It is typical for green politicians, they have no sense of economy. But you see, we reached 2011, 20%. Much more, much faster. It is possible when the political framework is right. And this political framework goes under one important headline. Let's earn money with climate protection technologies. Give a feed-in tariff that is high enough that the investment of private people is a profitable investment. This is the basic of the feed-in tariff law. And it works very, very good. Yes, we were told in the last year, when you phase out nuclear, you must buy a lot of electricity from the France nuclear power stations. No, it isn't. 2011, we cut down 8 nuclear power stations. And even in 2011, Germany was an electricity exporter. This February, we had a very hard winter in whole Europe. And because of the fact that France has a lot of electricity heating, they need a lot of electricity, double so high than Germany. Germany has more efficient isolated houses and others, and therefore they do not need so much electricity in winter time. But we had in this February a lot of wind and a lot of sunshine, and so we could help France with electricity. When we would not have this 20% renewables in the German grid, I believe France would have a blackout in electricity systems this February. Mostly it is otherwise than the public opinion told. And we see new situations. We were told last year, when you phase out nuclear, then your coal power stations come under pressure. They must produce so much electricity to equalize the nuclear cut down. Now it is otherwise. STEAG is the biggest coal operator in Germany. Now he announced a fortnight ago, they would shut down some nuclear power stations and would now change their business for renewables because coal power has no economic future. This is important for you here in Australia because a lot of mining operators want to sell coal to Germany. But we will close down it. And then this will happen also in the rest of the world, because solar and wind is cheaper than coal operating. Who will buy the Australian coal? I fear that a lot of investment in coal mining is stranded investment here in Australia. Netherlands, the same. Last year they announced they want to build up a new nuclear power station to serve Germany. They would need cheap electricity. No, they cancelled the plan because of, oh, there is so much electricity in the European grid because of the wind and solar in Germany. And this lot of renewables makes the electricity so cheap that they have no economic basis for a new nuclear power station. Not in renewables are expensive. They lower already the price on the German electricity stock market because of one thing. Every time when a lot of wind is blowing and a lot of sun is shining, we have so much electricity in the grid that the grid operators have to power down, at this time, other power stations. And firstly, they take the most expensive one. And when they do not produce electricity, the average price of the whole electricity will drop down. Renewables already lower the price of electricity in Germany. It is not an expensive burden. And it brings already a new economy. In 1998, we had 30,000 employment in the renewable branch. Today, we have 370,000. And it is not only in the new companies. We have a lot of thousands of new companies within 10 years. It is also in existing companies. The wind industry is the second biggest buyer of steel in Germany. It brings the steel industry a lot of new business. The solar industry is one of the biggest buyer of glass. It brings the glass industry a new big business. The German renewable branch is now the stabilization factor in crisis situation. During financial crisis, 2008 and 2009, it was the only branch in Germany who increased anymore and brought us new jobs. We have another country in the world who came as fast out of the financial crisis 2009 as Germany. It was China. Both countries have a right and successful strategy for renewables. Perhaps this is a reason why both countries come fastly out of the financial crisis. And often it is told it is a burden for the economy to go with renewables because of the higher electricity price. Yes, we have more costs because of feed-in tariff for the electricity consumers. 10% of the electricity price in about of the German electricity consumers. This is in the whole in 2011, 12 billion euro more cost. But these more costs are overcompensated on other points in the German economy. We could avoid import costs for oil, gas, coal and uranium by the amount of 9 billion. Where is the burden? And we could avoid external costs paid by taxpayers, not by the electricity consumers, by the way, waste management of coal power operators or others. We could avoid 20 billion euro by more cost of 12 billion euro. Renewables are no burden for the economy. They are already today a benefit. And this more cost are mostly the more cost we have to pay when the photovoltaic was very expensive 6, 7, 8 years ago. Today it is very cheap. The new investment into photovoltaic and others becomes more and more cheaper. This is a feed-in tariff, what we paid yearly in the next year for photovoltaic operating. Look to 2012, for big rooftop systems, we paid 18 cents per kilowatt hour. 20 cents the last year. And there happened one point. When we dropped down this feed-in tariff, the investment increased. Because of dropping down the production cost. Last month, in last year, in December, in Germany, were invested 3 megawatt photovoltaic in only 1 month. It is double the sum than Australia has in the whole photovoltaics. It is not difficult for the industry to switch Australia very fast to 100% renewables. And we have even new technologies who now can help to manage grid stability. Reactive current is very important for voltage stability, frequency stability, and others. Batteries combined with the new photovoltaic converters can produce reactive current, even in night, when no sun radiation is there. We can use it when we close down the coal power stations who bring this grid stability systems. We can use it also with photovoltaic systems now in the future. New technologies are already available for this. And the cost goes down. We see it. This is a study from Duke University in North Carolina. Not so many solar radiation, much more cloud than in Australia. But a new photovoltaic system, as a result of this study, produced cheaper electricity than a new nuclear power station. I cannot understand why Obama gives the allowance for new nuclear operators. Two, you remember, last week he announced it. But I saw he gives a lot of tax money that the nuclear operators will really go to operating. He could avoid this tax money when he goes to renewable electricity. And when you do not compare new investment with new investment, but old investment after financial period is over, there are more astonishing facts. This is a research from the Congressional Research Service from the US Congress in Washington. The cheapest variable cost, the cost what we need after financing is over, comes from solar and from wind. Much cheaper than coal or natural gas or nuclear. Today, and the price for the technology is dropping and dropping anymore. But it comes not by himself. Because what we see now in Germany is a process that the old companies fight for survive. They see the economic pressure from renewables and want to go on with nuclear and coal power station. Nuclear they cannot because we have a law to phase it out. But coal power not. But they see they come under economic pressure. And so they fight with the politicians to influence them, to make laws that do not bring renewables very fast. The laws what we would need to accelerate 100% renewables would be a lot of different laws. Firstly, we need a basic that the investment into renewables is profitable. This is a law for feed-in tariffs. Second is, we can give tax reliefs for renewables. And we must cancel subsidies for all what brings climate gas emissions. Carbon tax is very important. It can equalize the external cost that are not paid by electricity consumers. Congratulations to your carbon tax here in Australia. We need an offensive research program. There are a lot of technologies who are not yet really ready for mass market, but in research money we can give them, we can accelerate it. And we need an education offensive for renewables and organic farming and others. This education offensive is not only important on universities and schools to influence the young people, we need also an education for the elder people, by the way, politicians, managers and others. They must learn to go on with the conventional energies is a burden for the society, and renewables are the solution for this. No successful climate protection policies are quota or certificate systems or emission trading. Emission trading is not successful. But it is often discussed to take it instead of feed-in tariffs. Because a lot of people know when we can make emission trading, then we can give the opinion to the public, yes, we are doing a lot for climate protection. But in reality, it isn't. And they can avoid a good based functional feed-in tariff law. Look how important a good strategy with feed-in tariff is. Look, in the 90s, Japan was a world leader in photovoltaic systems. They had a very good subsidy program. Germany did nearly nothing. There was a feed-in tariff for photovoltaics, but not high enough to make a profitable investment. We made it in 2000 with the amending of the renewable energy law. And with the feed-in tariff law, Germany overcame Japan very fast, the world leader in photovoltaics. And you see, we have a lot of solar radiation in Australia, but nearly no photovoltaic systems. It is not because of the solar radiation, it is because of the not being feed-in tariff laws here. You have some, you had some in your states. They were successful, and so the coal operators fought it to cancel it. And they were successful, we see. But it is very important to take not any feed-in tariff law. It must be based on a very detailed, organized law system. We have about 60 feed-in tariff laws in the world. A very political successful story. But only a few of them work really very good. In Italy, in Spain, in Germany, in China. China set a target in the last 5 years plan for wind power, and this target was, because of the feed-in tariff, 5 times overfulfilled within 5 years. Key points of an effective feed-in tariff law are privileged grid access. You would need this in Australia because your grid operators are combined with the electricity producers. And the interest of the electricity producers to allow no competition leads that the grid operators will refuse it. We made a privileged grid access by law, and so everyone can come with his electricity into the grid. Yes, we have a border, but this border is only when the grid is full with 100% renewables. First, they have to cancel the production of nuclear or coal industry and natural gas. The feed-in tariff have to be sufficient. Funding must be paid via electricity rate, not by tax money. Because when you pay it by tax money, the finance minister will say next year, oh, my budget is over-debted, We must cancel feed-in tariff. This happened 2 years ago in Spain. There was very successful feed-in tariff law in Zola, and even they paid a too high feed-in tariff for photovoltaics, and then you can imagine what happened. A lot of investors came. And then the finance minister said, oh, my budget. And they canceled the law, and 20,000 employment were canceled within some months. Therefore, do not spread it on tax money, only by electricity price. Important is no cap for feed-in tariff, because when you make a cap for 1 year, the investors for a new manufacturing will say, oh, I don't know if in the next year we have enough big market. And they invest into factories only when they see a market that goes on for many years. This was a basic that a lot of manufacturers invested in Germany into the factories. A guaranteed period of remuneration. And really, this is outside of the feed-in tariff law. You need a very good functioning permission policy. We have some places in the world you get easier a license for nuclear power stations than for a wind power station. Perhaps not really. But what I hear sometimes with killing birds and others from people who never talk about on environment, suddenly in wind power, birds play a role. We can be happy, not everywhere in the world. The investment flows very fast, and the biggest leader in the world is now China. Firstly, only because energy hunger. But now they see also it is a very good climate protection strategy. And China is in front of a climate protection law. It would be the first in the world. Even Germany has no law for climate protection. And included in this approval, not approval, in this in this amending of this law, they include targets, regional targets for renewable energies. And these targets are very high in China. And in China, they have already in some regions in the northern part, nearly to Mongolia, they have the problem when they want to increase renewables, and they want to do it, they have to power down coal power stations. Then they will not buy coal from Australia, even China. It comes very fast, and China will now invest this year not only in wind power, where they are very successful, they will invest also in photovoltaic system. What I hear now, they make plans for gigawatt plants, some gigawatt plants. This is very good for the planet. It is a problem for our German technology leadership. Yes, it is. So you see, we have the chance to cool down the planet. We must make a new strategy that the investment will go to climate protection and not to climate polluting. And this is a task for the finance industry. Let's work together worldwide to make a new climate alliance with the finance industry. They can earn money. And this makes no problem for the environment when we go to such a way. We must take all renewables. All renewables are very important because some have problems like fluctuations. Other are stored renewables like hydropower or bioenergy. And when we take all renewables together with more efficient energy consumption, we can go very fast to such a climate protection strategy And when you want to hear more about this, in some months I want to publish a book. You can see here some flyers about it. Global cooling is possible. When you are interested, you can take some with you. It will be published in English, so you will have no problems. You are invited to join this, and I'm very happy to stay with you. And when you have some questions or comments, please, let's speak about it.